in general, there are two types of monitoring solutions out there. There are the active and the passive. Most monitoring solutions are passive. You know, they're based on some form of agent or system generating events, usually something like an SNMP trap, and then your monitoring solution having to work through all these events. This monitoring solution, you know, you're getting, you know, everything that's happening in the day-to-day life of your solution. It has it started up? Has it shut down something? Has it changed something? There's a lot of noise, a lot of unactionable events, and also lots of duplicates. You're basically spending most of your time trying to filter through these, saying, you know, have I already actioned this? What is it trying to say? Is the event still active? Maybe you're even missing events. The solution has issues, you know, at an architectural level. Rather than sitting there waiting to receive an event, hoping that it turns up, hoping that you can understand it properly, let's try an active solution. Active solutions go out to the system being monitored. They're not waiting for it to come back. They're not waiting or hoping that, you know, the system's still working, hoping that all the services, network connections are working and that the message will get back. It's sitting there, it's constantly asking the solution, what's your status? What should I be monitoring? What have you got in your system? So for instance, an active solution would take an inventory, make a list of all the components, make a list of all the part numbers, and then start asking it, you know, you told me you had 3 CPUs, okay, what's the status of all of them? If something goes down, you know not only what it is, where it is, what its part number is, the actions are clear. It's not some cryptic message, it's not some life story of the server. It's saying that I've gone out, I've asked you as the monitor element, what's wrong, and you've told me. Another advantage of an active solution is that you have a better idea of open and closing on events. With passive solutions, you have to look up and say, okay, is this like a log file? Is this message closing an event earlier? You know, is there a closed message? We don't know. Active solutions, we do know, because suddenly that server that's been telling us CPU 3 is down is now saying, well, somebody came along and CPU 2 is now fixed. So I'm saying you can close the case, or let's say if the issue was temporary, there was a problem, it went away, so don't bother fixing it. So let's take a look at the events that are generated by these two different systems and see how these concepts look in reality. Here we show a couple events from a passive solution. These are basically slightly enriched SNMP traps. They give you an idea of where a problem could be, where you should be looking, you know. But there isn't much more information here. You don't know the exact, you know, model of the server. You don't really know where it is. You don't really understand the message. You're going to have to look it up. It's not easy to process this. Next, let's take a look at an active event as generated by Sentry. Here we see the model of the system, the serial number, the exact location of the part that has failed, and any additional information about it. Let's say the model and serial number, and some other information that might have come through saying, you know, maybe it's telling you that the number of errors has exceeded the level. You get a real good understanding of what needs to be done and what needs to be actioned.